57. Shortly after, Prophet Muhammad told Bilal to call everyone, and he stood on the pulpit raising the saddle to the camera. He reminded everyone the message of Islam. Prophet Muhammad wasallam gave them advice, saying, when he is gone, he will leave behind two things. He said, one of the things is the Book of Allah, and the second is his family, the Ahlul Bayt. He stood up at Ladir home and proclaimed to everyone that not only the special relationship that was with him and Imam Ali alayhi salam, but also that he was the master of whom he was the master. He raised the hand of Imam Ali alayhi salam and said to the crowd, Man kuntu mawla fahada aliyun mawla. It says, of whoever I am the master, Ali is also his master. By saying this, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made Allah's declaration that Imam Ali alayhi salam was to succeed him as the rightful guide and the leader of the people. After Prophet Muhammad's sermon, the people celebrated and congratulated Imam Ali alayhi salam. And no one was as close to Prophet Muhammad as Imam Ali alayhi salam. No one possessed the knowledge of Prophet Muhammad except Imam Ali alayhi salam. No one sacrificed for Islam like Prophet Muhammad except for Imam Ali alayhi salam. For he was always by his side. Even when the time came for the Prophet Muhammad to go back to Allah, it was Imam Ali alayhi salam who was by his side, receiving thousands of pieces of knowledge. And finally, he was the one to wash his body and place it on the ground. So today, let us remember the honor of the brother of the Prophet Muhammad, the successor of the Prophet Muhammad, the protector of the Prophet Muhammad, the supporter of the Prophet Muhammad, and most beloved of the Prophet Muhammad. Ya Ali, Ya Ali, Ya Ali.
One last step, inshallah, brothers and sisters, before we start the real program, we have Brother Hasneen. Where is Brother Hasneen? Have a poem. He's going to read it for us. Please.
Hasneen Junior.
Junior. Oh, no.